what are the potential side effects of using 5-Amino-1-MQ? Now, I'm Regan Archibald. I've been obsessed with peptides for over a decade. We've helped thousands of people navigate how to best utilize these peptides. And in this video, I'm going to share with you some of the things that some of my clients have shared with me as far as side effects of 5-Amino-1-MQ. Most of the side effects are really positive, so we're going to focus on the things that we attribute to side effects, which are negative. But let's jump in. Have you ever heard someone say, I just feel like I have too much energy? I mean, it almost sounds like that's impossible, Regan, but this is literally the most common side effect I hear when it comes to 5-Amino-1-MQ is people feel enormous amounts of energy, but when we get them to the optimal therapeutic dose of 150 micrograms, that's when they can feel like it's just too much, like the acceleration is too intense. And if you think of what 5-Amino-1-MQ does, is it helps prevent the breakdown of NAD. So you actually get greater expression of NAD by a factor of about, 20 to 40%. And if you're increasing your NAD levels, for those who have ever done like an NAD drip, it can be intense. Or if you do a subcutaneous injection, that can be intense. Sometimes if you take it orally, but typically not. But what you'll feel is a little bit of nausea in your stomach, similar to where is you're getting that IV drip. You'll notice like, holy cow, I feel like nauseated, not like nausea, but almost like a pit in my stomach. And some of my clients, they've said, I feel a little jittery. I feel that pit in my stomach. I feel a little bit wired. And this is very nuanced. This is less than 1%. But I think it's really interesting because what you're doing is this rapid increase in availability of NAD. And NAD, by the way, there's a lot of these precursor supplements, and you hear all these people talking about increasing NAD and you're taking all these oral things. They're very expensive. Most of those just don't work that great. Even the NAD IV that you do, the same way you do a vitamin IV, there's just not a lot of data that shows that being utilized by your cells. But what we do know with 5-Amino-1-MQ is it's using your body's own NAD production and inhibits that NNMT pathway, and you get a greater expression of what's called AMPK. And then that allows your body to keep the NAD in free circulation, and it's your own supply. But just like getting NAD from an external source, you can feel like it can be a little bit, nausea inducing, or it can create a little bit of that like kind of wired effect. But in the long run, man, it is a great way of boosting your energy levels, increasing your muscle adaptation. It improves mitochondrial function, but it also burns fat. So the second side effect that I hear frequently is, people get stuck on GLP-1s, and we have a lot of clients that come over and they're like, I lost weight. I lost 10 pounds on these GLP-1s. And then I just kind of stalled out. It's frustrating for them. And I don't blame them. And so what we do is we say we need to work on other pathways. GLP-1 or the glucagon-like peptide, this is like Ozempic or Mounjaro, tirzepatide, semaglutide, the new one, retatrutide. These are all phenomenal peptides, and I've got a lot of videos. So go back through the YouTube channel and see if you like them, if you're interested in those. But you want to look at other pathways, and that's where like the NNMT pathway and the mitochondrial pathways are so powerful, and that's where 5-Amino-1-MQ comes in. But when you start losing weight, so I had one client and she was plateaued for about a year, and she's like, they're prescribing me the highest dose they can on Ozempic, and I don't know what to do. And she was really frustrated. So we ran her labs and we found out there's some issues with her thyroid, but we also realized that she's not making energy. She was so tired all day. And so we got her on the 5-Amino-1-MQ. And as she started losing weight, she didn't have the right support from a detoxification pathway perspective, and her stomach started to get upset. She started to get nauseated. When we pulled her down from 3 capsules back down to 2 or 100 micrograms, that's when she started feeling better. But then we added in more binders and we got her on a liver detox. And then we went back up to 3 and she felt amazing. And she lost 20 pounds in like 60 days. And so it was like her body just needed the energy, because if you think of detoxification, you got to have energy for detoxification. And if your mitochondrial pathways aren't working properly, if you don't have that right balance in the electron transport chain with like methylene blue, and if you're not getting the right NAD expression, it's going to really limit your body's ability to have this metabolic impact of burning fat, but not accumulating toxins, because the fat is where we store a lot of the toxins in our body. So the final symptom and side effect that I've seen is some people will get a little bit of a headache, or they can get a little bit of insomnia. Now, 5-Amino-1-MQ, it's not a stimulant per se, but when you start activating NAD, it's almost like now the engine's going and it doesn't want to turn off. And a lot of you, you know, you don't realize, you know, I hear it every day. It's like, I had no idea how much energy I was leaving on the table. Now I feel great, but I'm not sleeping as well, but I still have more energy. So one thing that happens where you can get the headaches is 5-Amino-1-MQ can increase nitric oxide. And when you increase nitric oxide, you get better vasodilation, you get better circulation in your body. And just as a byproduct, especially if you're not hydrated, you can get a little bit of headache symptom. And sometimes you can get muscle soreness. But this muscle soreness is because now your muscles are more engaged than they have been, because it does increase the contractility of your muscles by up to 70%. And so this is important, but by using like magnesium, that can be very helpful. You can also, you know, take some L-theanine, and that will calm down some of those brain waves at night. So here's a case study. This was a 44-year-old female. She was fatigued. She had stubborn weight gain. She had postpartum insulin resistance. So insulin resistance is her blood sugar just was all over the place. And she was 15 months postpartum. Her hemoglobin A1C was 5.6. And so we started her on a lower dose, the 50 micrograms of 5-Amino-1-MQ, as part of this metabolic reset. But as we increased it, weeks 2 and 3, she started noticing cramping and she felt jittery and she had a mild headache and some jaw tension. And she said, I feel like I'm getting too much energy too fast. And so we adjusted the dose back down, and then we added in the liver detox. We got her on N-acetylcysteine or NAC, and we added glycine in there. We got her on the glutathione nasal spray and the neuro NAD nasal spray, and then added in a little bit of magnesium glycinate. And she felt enormously better. She said by week 3, her energy was steady, no issues digestively. She was up to the therapeutic dose. Her hemoglobin A1C went from 5.8 down to 5.2 in just over 8 weeks. And she was able to reduce her waist circumference by 2.5 inches. And she said, I've had mental clarity that I haven't had in years. So 5-Amino-1-MQ, now that you understand the potential side effects, I've got a great video where I can show you what to stack with 5-Amino-1-MQ so you get the best benefits. And I appreciate you watching. I'm Regan Archibald. I'll see you in the next video.